A freshman from Lynchburg Park, Arizona, Alyssa. this time, fans, with the exception of cutouts, we ask that you please rise for the playing of our national anthem. Today's meet will be run with two events, alternating performances. So let's please move to your first event. The round counts will start on ball, LIU will begin on bars. There will be a 2-minute transition between events, and then a 4-minute touch.
Good afternoon. We are getting started right away here with the first competitive event of the UNH versus LIU dual meet. We have the Wildcats on vault and the Sharks on the uneven bars.
As you can see, the Wildcats are just doing their final team cheer before they get their competitors started. First up on vault, we will see Mariella Miel. And on bars, first up for the Sharks, we have Lauren Miller. Because it's a dual meet, we will alternate between one event to the other, one team to the other. So we'll see one vault, one bar routine, back and forth until the event is completed. Mariella's got her final prep from coach.
Last weekend, Mariella scored a 9.675 on vault. She'll be looking to raise that score today.
Just gonna run. Nice, clean, Yuchenko full.
Small step forward.
The judges are looking for solid landings. Mariella gets a little tight in the shoulders coming onto the vault, so she doesn't get the push she's looking for.
And here is Lauren Miller. This beautiful
nice
double layout to a stuck landing. Yep. Awesome start for the Sharks.
This is the second competition for the LIU Sharks in their university's history. We see Lauren's double layout, nice tight shape in the air and solid landing with just a little bounce.
All right, up for the Wildcats is Jenna DiVincenzo.
Another Yuchenko full here from Jenna. Strong run, tight hurdle. Excellent extension off the board. Just a step on the landing.
Again. Just step back. And up for the Sharks is Mika Takagi.
Getting the previous score finalized from Lauren's bar routine. Always a little nerve-wracking when you have to wait that extra moment waiting for the judges to be ready for your routine. So 9.55 from one judge, 9.55 from both judges, so the Lauren's routine will give her a 9.55, a decent start for the Sharks with the first rotation. Skill called a Veronin. Another toe on half to a straddle back. Those skills in combination give her lots of bonus points. Another toe on skill, toe on half front.
He's stuck landing. Awesome routine.
Let's take another look at that toe front dismount. Brings your toes to the bar, presses them off, flies with a half turn, and a nice landing. Claire just completed a nice tuck full vault. Take another look at that. See the knee bend to make the tuck shape. Nice solid full. Little stumble on the landing. Not too bad. See what the judges think about that. All of the routines, the girls are shooting to have a 10-0 start value. Different vaults have different start values because Lauren, the Yuchenko full has a 9.9 start value. So that's the maximum she could score.
And then up for the Sharks, we have Ella Castellanos.
Just still calculating the previous routine. One of the things on bars that the judges are particularly looking for is the full extension of handstands at the top of every cast, or when the girls transition from the low bar to the high bar to low bar. We want the armpits open, full extension, legs tight together. Here we see the judges are in a conference. There's a differential in their scores that's greater than allowed. Let's take a look back at some of that bar routine that they're deliberating over. The dismount again.
She definitely does a lot of unique combinations that aren't seen as much, so it could be something that needs to be discussed with the judges.
Looks like they have their start values differing also. So one judge is giving credit for some bonus points that the other judge is not, so they need to make sure that they have consistency in what they're looking at and judging from. On each event, we have two judges, one on each side of the event. And then there's a floor judge who oversees all of the judging, so that's why we have three judges collaborating right now. The floor judge is making sure everything stays equal, provides an extra opinion on what she's seeing and what the start values should be, what they're being given credit for. Usually they're a little faster in getting this resolved, but sometimes if it's as Nika's score routine had a lot of unique skills, it makes it a little more challenging to come to a consensus. They're back at their own judging tables, so we should be getting on. One more look back at that previous routine. Nika's toe on half to the Veronona. An example of where the judges would have been looking for a fully extended handstand as she landed on the low bar. And right there, that handstand also. And then dismount again. Nice solid stick.
And it looks like the scores for vault so far, we have a 9.65 for Mariella, a 9.75 for Jenna, and a 9.7 for Claire.
Consistent start for UNH on vault. the handstand.
Toe up.
Catches. Getting ready for a dismount. Oh dear. Looks like her grips just lost hold of the bar and slipped right off the bottom. Thankfully, she's up quickly. Hands right here, just slip.
The swing is definitely important for going into a double layout.
The gymnast has 30 seconds to get back up on the event, so she has time to regroup, take some deep breaths, and re-chalk her grips, get a better grip again. Gymnastics is such a mental sport. It takes so much to overcome and stay in control of your mind, control the body. Here she goes.
There we go.
Beautiful double layout.
Awesome.
Glad to see that she's able to stay on those feet strong. She runs through the arch of support from her teammates. And vault.
And digging.
Beautiful.
Awesome vault.
Such a dynamic Yuchenko full coming from Lauren. She nailed that land. Let's take another look. So strong on the table, pops off, she flares herself up into the air and nails her feet on the mat. Coach Lindsay, you can see how thrilled she is too.
Good to see her strong with that Achilles injury recovery.
Well, she's made quite a comeback from last season. Now she'll add another nice score to the vault lineup.
Next up for the Sharks is Allison Lack. Last weekend, Allison scored a 9.7 on bars.
See the gymnasts in the background dance to the music that's being played. It's a little bit different not having bleachers full of fans to keep the energy up around here. So the gymnasts are having to do it themselves. Keep encouraging one another. Keep the energy up. Should be a really good one.
It looks like we have a 9.4 for Nika.
Ready? See the gymnast putting their mask on a hook. LIU is using a garden hook to hold the mask of the competitor. Here goes Allison. Nice Maloney to Pat Salto combination. And that gives her 0.4 of bonus points. To add a couple more tenths of bonus by her dismount formation here. Giant, double layout. Slight hop on the landing, very clean. She should be pleased with that. Okay.
kick on the form. Awesome landing though. And that was Robin Kelly. Kuchenko full.
Another clean vault for UNH. See Lauren Diggins' score is a 9.825. Robin's hands here. One slipped. That's very impressive considering she only did a one-handed vault there.
Nice.
Getting both hands on the vault is so important to get the block and the height so that they have time to do the flips and the turns and everything and ready for their landing. Up on bars, we have Izzy Hilliard. And last week. Let's take another look at Robin's vault hand placement here. She gets good hands on the ground, hits the board nice and clean, but right here you'll see her right hand hardly contacts the table whatsoever. Yet she still gets good extension and height. Sees the landing and almost nails it, just one step. All right, we're ready for Izzy on bars. Beautiful handstand. She misses her toe hacked. Reverse hack, sorry. So again, right here, she's got 30 seconds to get back up on the bar and continue. This is just a little short on the rotation of her body to get a good grip on the bar. She can choose to redo that skill to get the credit for it or just move on. Salto. She's hitting her handstands quite nicely.
Down full to a double pike. A little short on that landing.
It's disappointing to have falls and fortunately, at college gymnastics as a team sport, they compete 5 to 6 gymnasts and only count 5 for teams.
Beautiful vault from Kylie Gorgini.
Lots of excitement on the vault runway for the Wildcats. Very strong end of their lineup. Look at the height and extension she gets off that table.
Small deduction on the landing. Awesome vault though.
Very solid 6 sets on vault for UNH. So as I was saying before, as we were at bars, the advantage of the college format is they compete 6 gymnasts and 5 of the scores count. So whatever the lowest score is gets dropped from the team total.
And we have Caddy Koopman up now for the Sharks. Last weekend she scored a 9.6 and she is going to be looking to bump that up, especially anchoring for this rotation for the Sharks. Definitely puts a lot of pressure on the last gymnast of the event when there are one or two falls previous, but you gotta push forward and hope for the best.
Wait. for the judges' green flag to give the go-ahead.
And it looks like that was a 9.875 for Kylie on vault.
That's an exciting score. That'll really boost the total for UNH. There, that'll cost a couple of tenths. So she needs to finish strong. Another clear handstand. Into a tuck full in with a solid landing. Chest was a little low, but she didn't move her feet.
See that disown again. A little short on those handstands.
Nailed it. Messed up on vault for UNH, doing an exhibition.
Uchenko half, and that was Maya.
She had a odd positioning on the board going into the table. It just changed her momentum and direction, trajectory of her body. It's great to get the athletes to do their exhibition routine. It doesn't count towards the team score whatsoever, but it gets them experience on the competition lineup. Let me take another quick look at Maya's vault here. There she goes. You can see, she just never really gets her feet and hands right where she wants them. But good for her for trying. We'll be back right after this break.
Thank you.
We've just watched our first LIU shark falter. We had Alyssa Van Allen competing on Leo Uchenko. You'll notice that LIU is only competing 5 vaulters today. My understanding is that as a new team, they are still waiting for NCAA clearinghouse for a few more team members who would fill out their vault lineup.
And we have Kennedy Brown starting off the second rotation for the Wildcats. She is a transfer sophomore from Alaska. And you'll see that vault really quick. Yeah. Small hop back.
I always wonder about those kind of stepping back finishes. Will the judges call those extra steps or not? UNH is looking to nail their handstands. That one's a little short. Kennedy got a first two nicely.
Nice release.
Another unique release skill. Covering up a little bit here. And pulling off a nice double tuck. Little improvisations at the end of the routine, but she stayed on and
that
she
was impressive.
Landed. Yep. See what the judges do with that one. There she goes. We're on ball. We have Yachenko full. From Lauren Miller. Well, she's all smiles, even though it didn't quite go as planned. Always good to know that the ladies are not injured when they have a crash landing like that, but gymnastics equipment has come so far. The landing mats are so absorbing and forgiving. Much thicker than they used to be a generation ago when it was my time.
We have Haley Louie on bars.
Yeah, the judges are still trying to figure out what they're doing with the first routine. Here's Lauren's vault again. Unfortunately, they're going to have to count this in their team score because they've only got 5 gymnasts vaulting today. So they don't have the flexibility of dropping the lowest score. LIU seems to have great spirits about it, though. Their team is mostly freshmen, as it is a new NCAA D1 team competing this year, so they haven't had years to build up their roster. They have a couple of sophomores, and the rest are freshmen. It's quite commendable to not have the experienced veterans leading the way, and being able to just keep the spirits up, and no matter what goes on the competition floor. Haley's ready to get rolling. Just kidding. Looks like the second judge is still calculating. We'll just dance to the music that's playing in the background. Stay cool and relaxed. In her mind as well, keeping her shoulders loose. You'll notice UNH is uniquely wearing pink this weekend. It is our Stick It for a Cure Cancer Awareness competition. It's one that we do every year to raise awareness and do a little fundraising for cancer. is going to have to wait a little longer here as the judges are going to have a little powwow, figure out what's going on. What do we do with those extra swing half turn to handstands? Straightened out. Looks like Haley's getting hungry. Trying to eat her toes. See in the background there the team members looking at some papers. They're probably taking a look at the inquiry sheet that they have for each gymnast's bar. The judges are questioning here with the half turn. She overdoes another half turn.
Yeah, it looked like she was going for a blindfold double and then was short on the blindfold. So then she swung and tried to do it half back and then
missed that one.
Yes, and then went to the dismount.
Yeah. Had to get herself reoriented in the right direction to do that double tuck. But
they should give some kind of credit for that.
Not sure if it gives her extra bonus or not.
Yeah.
Missing the handstands, though, to that degree, it probably takes it away.
Yeah.
I don't think that was the biggest concern at the moment when she was doing it.
Right. Just get to the dismount and exactly. Get off the bar.
Stay on our feet.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the team is looking at the routines and what's getting done and what the expected start value should be based on what the gymnast actually performs, what the judges are seeing. So if there's some significant discrepancy in the scoring, what their start value is, then the coach can submit an inquiry to the head judge and have it reevaluated. Here goes Haley. Haley's got such beautiful lines, full extension of the shoulders. Nice long legs and open hips.
Beautiful.
Hits the handstand. Let's see how she finishes this routine. She never rushes. She just goes at her nice, comfortable pace. Step forward on the landing. Nice, clean routine.
Here is Amanda Liu for the Sharks.
Every gymnast has their own way of getting ready for their vault. Amanda's got a unique format there. Pretty solid Yuchenko full.
Chest was a little low on the landing.
Leg separation on that giant full.
Looks like she might have clipped the low bar a little bit on the
possibly, yep.
Swing to the dismount.
Yep. Long legs like that, I can't imagine.
Yeah.
I'd be clipping my heels all the time. We saw Amanda's vault again. A little pike down on that landing. The judges are looking for a full straight extension right to the end of that vault. So there'll be a couple tenths deduction for the pike down.
Here is senior Claire Hanford.
Coach Lindsay giving her her final pep talk, encouraging her to breathe calm, stay focused. She's got this. We noticed throughout the competition that the gymnasts have different pep talkers before they compete. Someone might have Coach Lindsay, might have a different assistant coach, or even a teammate give them their pep talk. And the gymnasts really just get to choose what they want and that makes them click, that gets them in the right zone to do the best that they can. It's a real team effort. And so the judges looks like the judges are giving Haley 9.625 for that routine. Beautiful height, awesome connection. Kick their toes up on the overshoot. Never want to see the gymnast drag their feet when they transition to the low bar. It's been a big improvement this week. Double tuck, small hop.
Awesome.
Nice solid set.
Claire was missing from the lineup last week, so it's good to see her back in there.
Cats, we're missing a few of our bar lineup crew last week. And on vaults, we have Katie Koopman.
Tuck full,
short on the landing, touched a knee down. Take another look at Claire's bar ending. Nice legs together on the giant full, legs together on the double tuck. Solid finish. Back to vault. Tuck full Yuchenko. Just opens it up a little bit too early, so her rotation wasn't complete. Hops right up onto her feet and continues on.
I felt that one in my ankles.
Yes. A few short landings. Warming up the ankles is so important.
Yes. And we have senior Kylie Crotchwell next on bars. Last weekend she scored a huge 9.825.
It would be wonderful if she could do the same or even better.
Yeah. Beautiful handstand. It's a bail hand.
Tough to see on this angle how the judges call that handstand.
Leo.
Awesome. Oh, beautiful clean landing. Look how excited she is on that landing.
Awesome routine from Kylie.
Wow, that's going to be a close competition for last week's score.
Yeah, definitely.
Alana Ricketts. Still. Leo Yuchenko. Clean. Solid landing. Double it with full extension and that salute. Open hips on that Leo Yuchenko. Sometimes the simpler vaults are the ones that score a little higher because there's less opportunity to get deduction, less technical errors that happen. But being only a layout without a twist, the start value is a 9.75 instead of the 9.9s and 9.95s that you see for most of the twisting vaults. The end of the lineup for the LIU Sharks on their vault. So we'll see a couple of bar routines back to back now.
And it's looking like Kylie matched her 9.825 score.
We'll take it.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, Lauren was one of those we were missing last week. It's good to see her back today. Nice hop full. I love that skill. Right into it. Jaeger. Ganger, I had it right the first time. It's a unique way to do our straddle back from an undergrip. try on that handstand, but we'll see how she winds up for her dismount. Oh, almost stuck it.
Right there.
Trying so hard. That should be another decent scoring routine. Wildcats are looking pretty confident today. Their vault lineup scored their highest of the season so far. We still have Kylie coming up on bars. Instead of popping back to vault where there's no one else competing, we'll just wait on the judges and stay on bars. See the coaches talking with one of the LIU gymnasts. Quite the trio there. I think they've all been at UCLA either as staff or gymnasts at the same time in the past, recent past. UCLA is one of the top teams in the country. LA is very fortunate to have the experience coming to them. Again, 9.75 for Lauren Diggin. Miss Maloney. Overshoot to handstand. Fought for that handstand. Right into a toe up to the high bar. Another solid handstand. Looking for a full twisting double tuck here. And a stick.
Wow.
There is no arguing that was a solid stick.
That was a solid rotation for UNH.
Absolutely. How exciting. I don't think Kaylee's smile could be much bigger than that. It's ear to ear beaming. certainly a routine worth being pleased with. Let's take another look at that. Cranking up for her dismount. Full in, stick,
perfect.
And on that note, we'll be back after the next warm-up rotation.
Finish.
it's worth it.
Awesome. Definitely going to top her score from last week.
Back to LIU Sharks on floor. Some of the gymnasts have two tumbling passes, some of them have three. It really depends on where they can get their bonus points from to get their start value up to 10.0. Their base routine, when they have the minimum requirements, should start at a 9.5, and then they put skills together to build it up to a 10.0. And the judges take their points off for execution, form, extra steps. With whatever the maximum start value is. Having a little fun in the corner here. Double tuck. No extra steps whatsoever.
This bubbly routine, fun to watch.
Lots of personality coming out on that.
We got round off 1.5 front layout again.
Her legs are so tight in the air.
Yeah.
It's double tuck. They don't even separate on the landing. They just stay together.
She'll have no room for deduction there.
College, the gymnasts are allowed one controlled step out of the tumbling pass without deduction. That's when they go out of the blue line, blue square, or they have extra steps beyond the one allowed that they get deducted.
And we have Gia Graver up on the beam right now for the Wildcats.
Impressed when freshmen make the lineup on balance beam, especially. A little shaky on getting started there. Hopefully she'll recover with some solid dance and her other skills coming up. From the fall on the last. UNH will be looking to drop the score here. So the rest of the girls in the lineup will be trying to make sure they hit all the more. We can drop that score. So we'll have a judges' conference going on floor.
And we have Lauren Miller coming up for the Sharks on floor. Last weekend, she scored a 9.65.
Lauren is planning a three tumbling pass routine. So she'll get most of her bonus points out of her tumbling.
Awesome double pipe to open with.
Lots of height on that tumbling pass. And a quick return with our second pass. Front full, front layout. Again, nice nice clean form in the air, the legs together and straight.
Looked really strong.
LIU has some unique choreography. Their assistant coach Haley used to help us in the choreography at UCLA, and if you've ever watched UCLA's competitions, their routines are always super original. They really capture the individual gymnast personality. They get the crowd involved. They have a lot of fun out there. Coach Hallie's brought that with her over to LIU. It's a tricky leap combination. Switch leap half, straddle full, wolf full. Final tumbling pass here. Ground up 1.5, and front layout.
Worthington up on beam for the Wildcats. Starts off with a challenging series of a side aerial back handspring.
Changing direction in the air while upside down, no hands.
She makes it look easy.
Yes, she does. Showing off a little flexibility with the leg hold. Melissa gets lots of her bonus points from her dance combinations. Here we go, we have a stick. And a very excited team.
Good to see her back in the lineup.
She likes those aerials. Puts in combination in her tumbling series on the beam and to get off the beam for her dismount. Next up on floor, we should have Katie Koopman. Seen Katie on the vault and the bars already today. And we do expect to see her in the beam lineup, so she's an all-around competitor.
Next up on floor exercise for LIU, Katie Koopman.
We're expecting to see a pretty challenging first pass from Katie. Beam, we've scored. Hannah had 9.825. That's definitely topping her season best. And a 9.7 and a 9.2. That's the score we're looking to drop. We got one score showing for Long Island on floor so far, 9.75 from Amanda Liu. And here goes Katie. Triple twist.
Wow.
I don't see very many triples in college gymnastics.
Yeah, no.
It's really hard to get the full height and the full rotation on those to get the full credit of it. Triple twist is one of the highest skills by value that you can compete on for. Always look painful from the outsiders, but the gymnasts learn how to control the landing using their arms and the leg positioning, so it really doesn't hurt. Ready for a second pass. it's safe to say that Katie is a good twister.
Yes, definitely.
And again, she just has two tumbling passes, but the skill level that she performs is all she needs is the two passes.
Here is Robin Kelly.
I've noticed over a series of competitions that the gymnasts on balance beam have a consistent piece of music that they have playing in the background. We just saw Robin do a handspring, layout, step out, layout, step out. Can choose the music that they have in the background. It just helps keep them grounded and focused throughout their routine. It's not something they can do when there's more than two teams competing at the same time, but in a dual meet like we have going today, it's very feasible.
Another solid routine for the Wildcats.
That was rock solid. Not a wobble. Let's see that step dismount one more time. Handspring step out, 1.5 twist, boom. Fabulous.
Next we have Allison Lapp for LIU. Last weekend, Allison got a 9.675 in four.
See what Allison has for us. She's showing a little bit of heartbeat going in the start of this routine. On a handspring double pike.
Nice controlled landing.
Gymnastics choreography nowadays is more hip-hoppy. We've lost some of the artisticness of it. Allison is showing some of that artistic nature very nicely. Very expressive. Switch ring, switch half, wolf bow. It's a very difficult leap combination. She did very nicely. That's still on the floor very much anymore either. It's made a comeback in the international elite levels.
I like how much her dance is moving around the floor.
She does cover a lot of the floor area. Another good controlled landing. Got some goosebumps, haven't seen that routine.
Looks like we have a 9.9 for Alyssa on beam.
Wow. Right, here we go, Haley Louie. Just like on bars, you see a lot of long lines from Haley. She shows off her flexibility and a lot of her gymnastics. Unfortunately, she's just a little crooked going into the layout, so she falls. As she continues with her full turn. You see Kaylee taking very intentional breaths in different spots throughout her routine.
Yeah, you can see she has gained a lot of control and confidence in herself.
Sticks.
Great recovery from the fall.
Absolutely. a routine like this, but you've had a fall in the beginning, it just kind of takes away from the awesomeness of the stick. Like, oh,
yeah.
If only. But that's just the nature of gymnastics. Consistency has been an extra challenge, I would say, this year with the COVID situations that have put training times into limitation, and there's been quarantine seasons, and they just haven't been in the gym getting the repetitions that they're used to.
Definitely. And here is Reagan Jones. Gym being so quiet right now. Yeah, definitely.
UNH is off on the side, getting ready to transition to the floor rotation. And they had to count a fall on beam, but I think overall their beam performance was an improvement on what we've seen so far this season. Even with a fall, Haley scored a 9.325, and we scored Alyssa Worthington and Robin Kelly both got 9.9s. Super impressive.
Yeah, 9.375 is definitely still a very strong score with the fall.
If you add 0.5 onto it, it's almost a 9.9 again. Judges stepping out to the middle of the floor to conference about their previous score. Looks like they're talking about her last pass. Some of the gymnasts really got into the pink theme today. UNH seems pretty relaxed down on the floor today. It's nice being in the comfort of your own home gymnasium.
Yeah.
Don't have to worry about the bus ride, eating on the roads.
Yeah.
Being the first team to compete against Long Island in their inaugural season, and it's just an honor to be that first team and being able to support them. And usually the teams will be meeting up against each other 3 weeks in a row during the regular season. It's highly unusual, but due to COVID restrictions and flights being stopped for competitions, I should say, the team not being able to fly to competitions. UNH needed to, and LIU, they needed to fill their schedule with more local competitions, and so UNH and the Sharks are meeting each other a little bit more than usual for one season, but it's all good experience no matter what.
Yeah, and definitely really cool to be a part of history.
Yes, absolutely. Judges are ready to take a look at this final floor routine from LIU. Riley Goldberg. Coming.
And that completes our third.
She just doesn't get her feet quite underneath in the right way for a rebound and a front layout. Doesn't get enough rotation there.
Good fight though.
Mm-hmm. Again, instead of taking 0.5, she probably took 0.3 of deduction on that. So the teams are gonna get ready to rotate to their final event. Long Island's total at this point is a 141.65. And UNH is running at a 146.550, definitely their highest of the season. Let's see how they finish off their meet on their final rotation. We'll be back. Welcome back. We're here for the final rotation of Long Island University versus UNH, the Wildcats hosting. We've had a pretty solid meet so far this year. Today, I should say. It's the best meet of the year so far. At least they're on track for that. I had an exciting beam rotation with 299s and a 9825 and 9775 in their top four scores. We're just getting ready for the floor rotation, the event where we can let loose and have extra fun.
Definitely the most expressive event.
I believe we're going to start watching LIU beam. Alyssa Van Allen going first. Flexibility to get her started. She's getting a handspring step out, layout step out on the series. rest of the rotation. So coaches are anticipating that Alyssa can handle the extra pressure.
Yeah, it's definitely important to put someone that you can rely on in the number one spot.
Beautiful jump series there. Knows right where the beam is under her feet. Showing the best of control, but otherwise that was a very solid team. Looking for our first floor competitor.
We have Mariella Mealy. Mariella was in the lineup last weekend and scored a 9.55.
She's ready for a good time. Whipped a super high double pike, unfortunately over-rotated.
Didn't know what to do with all that power.
Yeah.
The adrenaline definitely kicks in.
I was just gonna say, perhaps a little adrenaline coming in. Still gonna make the best of it out there. Today. We're going to do our best to finish up with a smile. Lots of energy and power in that routine. Sometimes it's just hard to control it.
Especially going into the first event, you are just first routine of the last event.
A beautiful pass. She just pulled it in a little too tight on that second salto, second rotation. Just didn't need to pike it so tightly. Lost sight of the landing. Have Ella Barrington on the balance beam. Where they've had a little extra enthusiasm. Perhaps their adrenaline hasn't calmed down enough yet. It's always hard to settle right into the beam routines. It's the hardest mental event of all gymnastics. Kathy, side aerial. Found her center there. Stayed on. Split half. She's fighting for every landing here. That's what you gotta do. Never give up.
Awesome finish.
Under the bridge of applause. Look how easy she makes this landing. Spots it, holds it, full control.
And we have freshman Sierra Bauman on floor for the Wildcats.
Next up on the floor.
first time in the competition. The teammates are depending on one another to keep the hype going. No fans to do it here in person, so I'm sure they're sensing your cheering from online.
I feel like floor is where the no fans really stands out the most. Especially with those routines that try and get the audience engaged. If there's no audience, definitely
a lot
harder.
Yeah, who are you performing for besides the judges?
Right.
Nice punch, 1.5 to open up for floor team here. NCAA gymnastics, they are allowed a controlled one step out of their tumbling. However, it's always best to have some choreography to disguise any possible out of controlness.
And here is Katie Koopman.
Nice triple series. Full turns.
Yeah, they get you.
Doesn't matter what level you are, it's always the full turn. Regaining her center. Twist dismount off the side of the beam.
Solid landing.
Sometimes those are the heart stoppers when the gymnast goes off the side intentionally, but the audience doesn't realize it.
Yes.
See that gainer pull again. Out of a switch leap. So she gets some bonus combination points for that. Nice clean landing.
Is Ali Kusich.
You can see a lot of personality come out on this routine.
Yeah. Definitely fun to watch.
Yes.
Pass.
Beautiful, Rudy. See those front twist passes. This one's tricky because it's a blind landing. It's hard to get all the way around that double twist. Rudy is on 1.5, so she can see the floor before she gets her feet down. She did a nice job keeping her chest at a decent height for that landing. She didn't pike it down.
And we have Taylor Dolan up on beam for the Sharks.
Sierra had a 9.75 on floor. And Katie Koopman, who we last saw on beam, had 9.525. Turn with the leg up. Full turns are hard enough as they are just with a regular footing, and now she throws her leg up high above her head, makes it even harder.
Yeah, she has some really impressive dance. I think she did a ring jump in the beginning.
Every gymnast has different strengths. Sometimes it's the tumbling skills, sometimes it's the dance skills. The routines are customized to each girl, each gymnast, whatever suits them the best. Know these gymnasts, working with them in the gym all the time, so it helps in the choreography. And 1.5. You see Claire using that extra mat again. This makes that takeoff a little bit easier on the body. Having a little fun here.
I know Claire does her hopes out with most of the choreography for the team also, so she definitely knows what to do.
It's really about interpreting the personality in conjunction with the music, telling a story out on that floor. Claire pulled that pass off. Looked like it was gonna be a little troublesome. She stayed on her feet. First pass here, 1.5, stands it up nice and tall. Oftentimes you see the gymnast hiking their legs down with their chest low to the ground, more like that.
She pulled it off.
Don't want, but hey, she stayed on her feet. And we have another pause at beam as the judges confer with one another.
Looks like for LIU, we have Alyssa with a 9.475. And there was a 9.775 for Allie Kusich for the Wildcats. And a 9.075 for Ella for LIU.
Noticed UNH has a lot of underclassmen competing regularly in their lineup this year. Often just reflects the makeup of the team across the years. So they've only got, I believe, 2 seniors this year. So there's not a lot of seniors to choose from to be in the lineups. So that means there's more freshmen and sophomores that are filling those lineup spots. I have to say, they've been doing a nice, confident job of stepping up to the plate early on in their college careers.
Next up on balance beam will be a left on the base.
There's three seniors. Claire, Kylie, and Lauren.
And there's one more, Hannah Roderick.
Oh, that's right. I haven't seen her on the lineup yet. Makes for a very competitive environment to earn your spot on the lineup for competitions. We have a team of 18, 20 or so team members, and only six compete on each event. You've got to be able to show consistency and dependability in the training days to earn your place in that competition floor.
So
we urge one another along in practice to continue making the team better. Here's the green flag from the head judge on beam. Alana Ricketts. Canadian. She has a little hang time up there. Even on her leap, she just gets up there and pauses.
Yeah.
Amplitude is something the judges are looking for. You want to see gymnasts get above their hip height, showing 180 degrees in their split. Split, I would say that one was a little short. Finishing strong with a handspring. Tuck 1.5.
That was unique. I feel like I don't see that much.
Yeah, the tuck shape is not common. Green mask. Let's take another quick look at that. Tuck 1.5. Her knees are bent. A little short on the rotation, so she had to tuck backwards.
And then here's Haley Louie.
Flexibility, her hips are like double jointed or something. It's crazy. It's like the Barbie doll twisting her leg around. Starting off with a front double twist and a choreographed scale step out of it. Switch ring. Highlighting her flexibility and the fluidity of her movement. Haley only has two tumbling passes, and they're both forwards tumbling passes, so she does that little side pass as a round off layout step out of her to just fulfill the requirement of having a back pass as well as a front pass like this is. Front layout, front 1.5, solid. Outstanding floor routine. Outstanding, Haley. Punch, two twists in the air. Looks like a big step out, but she adds that leg scale in the back.
Good control.
Good chest up on that last pass, too. You don't want to show your fatigue at the end of the routine, so it's extra important to accent the last pass with this upright landing. It's the last impression you're giving the judges before they give you the score. So here we go on beam.
Beautiful mount.
It's nice to see some unique skills. The handstand front walkover. She was on, it's unfortunate.
Beam is one of those events where everyone seems to just jump back up on the beam.
Well, the number of times that you've fallen in practice, what else do you do?
Yeah.
You just get back up and keep going.
I know for me, I like to act like it didn't happen, but you're just getting up right away and be like, okay.
Don't give your mind the chance to realize what just happened.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't want to break the rhythm. Much as muscle memory, and you don't even realize half the time what you're doing because you just do it automatically after repetitions, after years and years of training. Cute little hand toss of the hair in the back. Round off. 1.5. 1.5 is a very common dismount we're seeing on beam. See a lot of the gymnasts do either a back handspring or an aerial into their full or 1.5 dismount, but she just did her round off landing 2 feet.
And here's Robin Kelly.
Excited to get her first pass going. Front tuck through double tuck. Controlled step. Shouldn't be a deduction on that. Right there. Front arrow that just lands, flop on her back.
Really cool.
Getting her teammates on the sideline, cheering her on, helping her out with her dance. Helping her up to this pass. Double pike, beautiful height. Well, you see her footsteps on the white, that'll be an out of bounds deduction. 1/10 deduction. Lots of energy out on the floor today.
Yeah. Lots of excitement. Here's that first pass. Makes it look effortless.
She gets great height. Across the floor for her landing. Even at the last pass, she has so much energy left. And she gets bonus points for doing that double salto as a last pass also. So next up on beam, I believe we have Nika. Exhibition routine.
And it looks like we have a 9.65 for Claire, a 9.9 for Haley, and we in on Robin's score.
9.9 for Haley, that's exciting. See, this is where we see the difference of not having fans, because we would have heard a huge cheer for that score.
Yeah, definitely.
Broadcast booth, we didn't even know. There goes Nika. Seems like LIU is doing the same customized selection of music to go in the background during their routines. Full turn, gets her foot down right away so she doesn't lose any points from a wobble. Doesn't quite make the half turn, but she recovers nicely on her split jump. Mm-hmm. repeat the front aerial. She must be doing a combination here. She needs the credit for it. She also needs to get her second foot down so she can get credit for it.
It's a little short.
That time she got her second foot down so she can move on. She at least has the value of the skill counted in her skill value. Sami. Surprise.
No.
Standing full off combination for a dismount. It's one of those. Surprise!
No.
I wasn't expecting that. That's a tough one. A side Sami into an immediate layout full. You really got to have a secure landing on the side Sami.
Yeah.
It's a brave routine.
Here is Maya on the floor.
Exhibition routine, giving Maya some extra practice under pressure of judges. Nice high double kite.
Another fun routine.
Not just the dance, it's the facial expressions I give it up to.
Right.
I like how compact her wolf jumps are. Really make sure to get the full rotation on around.
Again with the energy at the end.
Lots of fun. She should be pleased with that routine. So, that was the last routine of the day. And so it looks like UNH finishes with a 195.35. LIU finishes with a 188.85. So for UNH, that's a big improvement from their last meet. It's actually their season high so far. They should be pleased with that. Next week, they'll be heading back to LIU for a quad meet. So it's a good place for them to hit the road from. It's been a pleasure being here with you guys today. Thanks for joining us. Signing out, I'm Alana Lapine. And
I'm Danielle Liska.
We'll see you next time.
Thanks.